You don't have to worry, 'cause baby, there report is on Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone by J.K. Rowling. Copyright 1990.
Good morning, and welcome to our 2021 Lower School Oratorical Program. We are so glad to welcome our audience, both here in the Cramer Center and via our live stream in our Lower School classrooms and at home. Our program this morning will begin with our junior kindergarten students reciting the days of the week and months of the year, followed by our third graders presenting about their favorite children's books. Now, Jameson, what do we need to say?
Let the show begin.
Let the show begin!
Thank you.
Steward is on Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone by J.K. Rowling. Copyright 1997. I like it when Harry plays his first Quidditch game at Hogwarts and catches a snitch in his mouth. I think it's hilarious. Thank you.
Reporting on is titled The Three Little Pigs. It was retold by Barbara Brenner. It was first published in 1933. My favorite part of the book is when the wolf climbed down the chimney and fell into the pot of boiling water. I like that part because it is funny.
Hi, my name is Charlotte Rose Arnold. The book I am reporting is titled The Kissing Hand. It was written by Audrey Penn. The date of publication for my book is 1993. My favorite part of the book is when Mrs. Raccoon told Chester about the kissing hand, and then Chester kissed his mother hand after Mrs. Raccoon kisses. This book is one of my favorites.
Hi, my name is Grayson Thomas Bernier. The book I am reporting on is titled The Art Lesson. It was written by Tommy DePaul. The date of publication for my book is 1994. My favorite part of the book is when Tommy draws on his bed covers, and when his mom found out, she said, "No more drawing on your sheets, Tommy."
The book I am reporting on is titled A Fish Out of Water. It was written by Helen Palmer. The date of publication for my book is 1989. My favorite part of the book is when the firemen have to put the fish in the pool because he is too big for the basement.
Hello, my name is Harper Heck, and the book I am reporting on is The Runaway Bunny. It was written by Margaret Wise Brown. The date of publication for my book is 1970. My favorite part of the book is when the mama and the little bunny were huddled in their den. This was one of my favorite books when I was younger, and it still is.
Hi, my name is Finley Olaf. The book I'm reporting on is titled I Am Enough. It was written by Grace Byers. The date of publication for my book is 2018. My favorite part of the book is when they say you do not need to look like someone or have the same color hair. We can all be friends no matter what. I like that part because we should be able to play no matter what. Thank you for your listening.
My book is Brown Bear, What Do You See? It was written in 1967 by Bill Martin Jr. And the pictures are by Eric Carvel. Animals in the book are black sheep, goldfish, green frog, red bird, brown bear, yellow dog, blue horse, purple cat, white dog. I like the book because bears are one of my favorite animals.
Hi, my name is Lily Kersey. I read Miss Nelson is Missing. The author is James Marshalls. It was published in 1977. It has a big twist at the end. My favorite part is when the kids have a mean substitute and they have so much homework that they were walking to Miss Nelson's house to make sure he's okay. But then they saw the mean sub and they went straight back home. You should really read it to find out what happens next.
Hi, my name is Jacob Gallo. The book I am reporting on is titled Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. It was written by Bill Martin Jr. The date of publication for my book is 1989. My favorite part of the book is when all the letters fall and had scratches and like stub toes, and they all rhymed with a letter, for example, skinny D, and I like it because I love rhyming books.
Hi, Parker Bowen. The book I am reporting on is titled Hans Lindgren. It was written by James Marshall. The date of publication for my book is 1990. My favorite part of the book is when they eat the candy house because candy is delicious. And I'm glad they don't get eaten by the witch.
Hello, my name is Landon Vassis, and the book I am reporting on is titled Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. It was written by Judy Barrett, and it was illustrated by Ron Barrett. The date of my publication for my book is 1978. My favorite part of the book is when hot dogs were raining into the restaurant and people were going crazy about it and seeing the huge Jell-O mansion.
Hi, my name is Richmond, and the book I'm reporting on is titled Pizza Cat. It was written by James Dean. The date of publication for my book is 2008. My favorite part of the book is when Pete turns his shoes blue because of the blueberries. I like it because one of my favorite colors is blue.
Hello, my name is Laurel Leah Kaufman. The book I am reporting on is titled Green Eggs and Ham. It was written by Dr. Seuss. The date of publication for my book was 1960. My favorite part of the book is when he tries the green eggs and ham because it shows how if you try something, you might change your mind if at first you didn't like it.
The book I'm reporting on is titled Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. It was written by J.K. Rowling. The date publication for my book is 2000. My favorite part of the book is when Harry's in the Triwizard Tournament maze because there are so many monsters and riddles. When Harry found the Triwizard Cup, I was so happy.
Hello. My name is Samantha Preston, and this book I'm reporting on is called Goodnight Moon. It is written by Margaret Wise Brown. It was published in 1947. I like the book because it has good illustrations. I liked it when I was little, and it was one of my favorites because it rhymed. And I loved rhyming books. That's why I chose this book.
Hi, my name is Zion Davis. My favorite children's book is The Little Brood Chuck by Alan Chertle. It was first published in 2008. I like this book because the little brood Chuck is friendly and fun and used teamwork to get his friend out of trouble and make his day.
Hi, my name is Ty, and the book that I'm reporting is titled Bear Snores On. It was written by Carmel Wilson and Jane Champion. The date of my publication for my book is 2002. My favorite part of the book is when the rabbit chewed, the badger chomped, and the mouse crunched, and Bear Snores On. And I really liked the book because Bear keeps snoring and that there's lots of small animals.
Hi, my name is Tabitha. I can follow Jimmy. The book I'm reporting on is titled The Stinky Cheese Man and Other Fairly Stupid Tales. It was written by John Shuscut and illustrated by Lane Smith. The date of publication for my book is 1992. My favorite part of the book is when they made The Princess and the Bowling Ball. It is a story about a queen and king who only let their son marry the princess who could feel a pea through 100 mattresses. When he found the princess he liked, when she slipped over, he put a bowling ball through under the mattresses. They eventually got married. I liked it because she didn't notice the bowling ball when she woke up.
Hi, my name is Watson Mundy, and the book I'm reporting on is called Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day. It was written by Judith Vorst, and the date of publication for my book is 1972. My favorite part of my book is when Alexander says the teacher likes his friend's picture of a sailboat more than his picture of an invisible castle. But really, there wasn't anything on his paper. Thank you.
My name is Zachary. I'm going to be doing The Night Before Christmas.
Got it.
It was the night before Christmas, not all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, hopes that Saint Nick soon would be there. When out on the lawn, I heard such a clatter. I sprang from the bed to see what was the matter. I knew in a what to my wondering eye should appear, a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a lively old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. As I drew my head, as I was turning around, down the chimney, Saint Nick came with a bound. He spoke not a word and went to his work. He filled all the stockings and then turned with a jerk. He sprang to his sleigh and gave his teeth. His teeth gave a whistle. Away they all flew like the down of a thistle. I heard him exclaim before he drove out of sight, "A Merry Christmas to all and all a good night."
When I was 1, I had just begun. When I was 2, I was nearly new. When I was 3, I was hardly me. But when I was 4, I was not much more. When I was 5, I was just alive. But now I am 6. I'm as clever as clever, so I think I'll be 6 for now, for 6. Now, forever and ever.
The me who isn't exactly what. Knock, knock, who's there? Me who? That's right. What's right? Me who? That's what I want to know. What's what you want to know? Me who? Yes, exactly. Exactly what? Yes, I have an exactly what on a chain. Exactly what on a chain? Yes. Yes, what? No, exactly what? That's what I want to know. I told you exactly what? Exactly what? Yes. Yes, what? Yes, it's with me. What's with you? Exactly what? That's what's with me. Me who? Yes? Go away. Knock, knock.
Hello, my name is Aria, and today I'm going to be reading I Wish You More. I wish you more ups than downs. I wish you more give than take. I wish you more tippy toes than deep. I wish you more we than me. I wish you more hugs than Uggs. I wish you more woo-hoos than woes. I wish you more will than hill. I wish you more can than not. I wish you more snowflakes than tongue. I wish you more pause than fast forward. I wish you more umbrella than rain. I wish you more bubbles than bath. I wish you more treasure than pockets. I wish you more stories than stars. I wish all of this for you, because you are everything I can wish for and more.
Hi, this is Campbell, and I'm going to be reading Hot Food. Hot food. We sat down to eat, and the potato is a bit hot, so I only put a little bit on my fork, and I blow to cool, just cool, then into the mouth. Nice. And there's my brother. He's doing the same. Toots cool, just cool, into the mouth. Nice. There's my mom. She's doing the same. Toots cool, just cool, into the mouth. Nice. But my dad, what did he do? He stuffs a great big chunk of potato in his mouth, and then that really does it. His eyes pop out. He flaps his hands. He blows. He puffs. He yells. He bobs his head up and down. He spits the potato all over his plate, and he turns to us and he goes, "Watch out, everybody. The potato is really hot."
Hello, my name is Gabby, and I'm going to read Brown Bear, Brown Bear. Brown Bear, Brown Bear, what do you see? I see a red bird looking at me. Red bird, what do you see? I see a yellow duck looking at me. Yellow duck, what do you see? I see a blue horse looking at me. Blue horse, what do you see? I see a green frog looking at me. Green frog, what do you see? I see a purple cat looking at me. Purple cat, what do you see? I see a white dog looking at me. White dog, what do you see? I see a black sheep looking at me. Black sheep, what do you see? I see a goldfish looking at me. Goldfish, what do you see? I see a teacher looking at me. Teacher, what do you see? I see children looking at me. Children, what do you see? I see a brown bear A red bird, a yellow duck, a blue horse, a green frog, a purple cat, a white dog, a black sheep, a goldfish, teacher. That's what I see.
Hello, my name is Charlie, and I'll be reading Be the Nice Kid. Be the Nice Kid by Brian Scatnick. Some kids are smarter than you. Some kids have cooler clothes than you. Some kids are better at sports than you. It doesn't matter. You have your thing, too. Be the kid who gets along. Be the kid who does, who is generous. Be the kid be the kid who is happy for others. Be the kid who does the right thing. Be the Nice Kid by Brian Scatnick.
Store Sacks by Patrick Bulger. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, the director of stores almost named Luke Skywalker's character Anakin Sarkler. I think it made a good choice. Did you know that three of the aliens from the movie E.T. appeared in Phantom Menace? Another fun fact is that two actors played Darth Vader in The New Hope. One actor did his voice, the other actor is the one you see walking around. In the three most recent movies, BB-8 is played by a real robot. However, in the original Star Wars movie, there was an actual actor inside R2-D2. In fact, the cast often forgot he was in there when they left the set for lunch. Did you know that Chewbacca's voice is a combination of badger, lion, seal, and walrus? R2-D2 and C-3PO are the only characters to appear in every Star Wars movie except for the Solo movie. The line, "I have a bad feeling about this," appears in every Star Wars movie. The Force is a mysterious energy field that binds the galaxy together. Jedi's on the light side are one with the Force and they're good. Sith Lords on the dark side use the Force for evil. Anakin Skywalker starts off as a Jedi, but eventually his anger gets the best of him, and he joins the dark side and turns into Darth Vader. But just before he dies, he saves his son Luke from the evil Emperor prompting. It's his best to use the Force for good, and is there to start doing good, even if you're Darth Vader. Thank you, and may the Force be with you.
What did the teacher tomato say to the student tomato?
What?
You better catch up.
Why can't you make a dinosaur omelet?
Why?
Because they are extinct.
What did the teddy bear say after dinner?
What?
I'm stuffed.
Where do pencils like to go on vacation?
Where?
Pennsylvania.
What do you call a bear with no teeth?
What?
A gummy bear.
How do you make a tissue dance?
How?
You put a little boogie in it.
Why is the cheetah so bad at hide and seek?
Why?
Because it was always spotted.
Why did the student eat their homework?
Why?
because their teacher said it was a piece of cake.
What state has the most laundry?
What state?
Washington.
Why does the basketball player go to the doctor so much?
Why?
To get more shots.
Hi. We're on our way by on. We're on our way by trolley, by train, by foot, by sleigh, by cab, by car. We're on our way by boat, by bridge, by bike, by bus, on wheels, on wings. Each one of us has dreams in our pockets and stories to share as we open up doors to school. Everywhere, and a rain might mist, a wind might blow, the sun might shine on our morning hello, and a storm might brew in the sky. Let it try, but the magic of wonder won't pass us by. We're on our way to school, by Rebecca Kai Dochlich.
I'd rather be fishing most any time, morning or evening, rain or shine. Just show me the tackle and give me some bait. Then watch me go fishing. All the rest can all wait. I catch them, I'll clean them, I'll cook them up fast. And when we start eating, they surely won't last. I'd rather be fishing most any time, morning or evening, rain or shine.
Dogman presentation by Nick Preston. Dogman is a comic. He is half dog, half man, and all hero. The author and illustrator is Dave Pilkey. His newest book in the series is Dogman Mothering Heights. It is his 9th book. The book before that was Dogman Grime and Punishment. My favorite in the series of Brawl is Brawl of the Wild. What's yours?
Oh, have you looked in the mirror lately? Wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion. But your skin, it glows like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you'll be given birth. Took everything in life, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus view. When you're in the room, they notice you, because you're beautiful. Yeah, you're beautiful. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching, they all adore you. If ever you are in doubt, remember what Mama told you. Brown skin girl, your skin is just like pearls. You're back against the world, I'll never trade you for anybody else. Brown skin girl, your skin is just like pearls. The best thing in all the world, I'll never trade you for anybody else.
The Actor by Paul Fleischman.
I see a strike.
I ape the gull. I sing just like the cardinal. I mimic hoots. I mirror crows. I imitate the orioles. I copy wrens. I echo owls. I know by heart the catbird's calls. But all of that is simply sham, for a mockingbird is what I am.
The loss we carry, Asemius Wade, we brave the belly of the beast, we've learned that quiet isn't always peace, and the norms and nations of just isn't always justice. And yet the norms ours before we knew it, somehow we do it, somehow we weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We the succeeders of the country in a time where a skinny black girl descends from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from published, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge a union with repose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, and condition of man. And so we lift our gazes, not what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe and nothing else say it's true. That even if we grieved, we grew. That even if we hurt, we hope. That even if we tried, we tried. That we'll be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again show division. We'll rise from the gold-limbed hills of the west. We'll rise from the wind-swept northeast, where our fathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake-rimmed cities of the Midwest states. We will rise from the sun-baked south. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover. For there's always light. If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it.
Hi, I'm Audrey, and this is my poem. Peace is more than peace. Peace is what keeps us together. It keeps love running. Love is the world. Peace is the world. You can change the world.
My elephant is different than most elephants I meet. Its ears are short and fuzzy. It has feathers on its feet. It's scaly like a lizard, and it's furry like a skunk. It sports a sort of auger where there ought to be a trunk. It doesn't much resemble other elephants I find. Its tail is like a mushroom on its tiny blue behind. It cackles like a chicken, and it's 14 inches tall. At times I think my elephant's no elephant at all.
If you always try your best, then you'll never have to wonder about what you have could done if you summoned all your thunder. And if your best was not as good as you hoped it would be, you could still say, I gave today all that I had in me.
The Steward School is really cool because everyone's nice and no one is cruel. We are lucky to see each other face to face. I think of this every time I say grace. At recess, we play tag, and it makes me so very glad. Coach Watkins is the drop-off king. Everyone knows his jokes are the very best thing. So that we're all on the same page, my best friend Gage is all the rage. I'm even willing to scream it on stage. I love Miss Moore. She is anything but a bore, and she's good to her core. Miss Lunsford teaches us more than just words and has the sweetest voice I've ever heard. And now my Steward poem is done, and I look forward to all that's fun in 2021.
Smart. My dad gave me $1 bill because I'm his smartest son. And I swapped it for 2 shiny quarters because 2 is more than 1. And then I took the quarters and traded them to Lou for 3 dimes. I guess he don't know that 3 is more than 2. Just then, along came old blind Bates. And just because he can't see, he gave me 4 nickels for my 3 dimes. And 4 is more than 3. And I took the nickels to Heron Cobb's down at the seed feed store, and the fool gave me 5 pennies for them, and 5 is more than 4. And then I went and showed my dad, and he got red in the cheeks and closed his eyes and shook his head, too proud of me to speak.
The ant and the grasshopper. It was a summer, hot and sunny, and instead of working and preparing for winter, Grasshopper was dancing, singing, playing in the field. Grasshopper saw a hard-working ant passing by him, carrying corn for the hard winter that was to come one day. Grasshopper invited Ant to join him and share his fun. "Unfortunately, I don't have time for this," Ant answered. "I must work hard so that winter won't find me without shelter and food." "Stop worrying so much. There is still plenty of time to prepare for winter. Let's sing, dance together. Let's laugh and enjoy life." But Ant was very wise and wouldn't pay attention to Grasshopper's words. Ant continued to work hard and store food for the long winter that was to come. The winter came sooner than expected, and Grasshopper found himself without a home and without food. "I should have followed Ant's example in the summer," the grasshopper thought sadly. "I would have been so happy now."
How not to have to dry the dishes. If you have to dry the dishes, such an awful boring chore. If you have to dry the dishes instead of going to the store, and if you have to dry the dishes and you drop one on the floor, maybe they won't let you dry the dishes anymore.
Hi, I'm doing jokes. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Alaska.
Alaska who?
Alaska you one more time to start the jokes. Where do polar bears keep their money?
Where?
In a snowbank. What do you get if you cross a tortoise with a porcupine?
What?
A slowpoke. Why did the golfer wear 2 pairs of pants?
Why?
in case he got a hole in one. How did the police officer sleep at night?
How?
Undercover. What did the bat say to his friend in the morning?
What?
How are you hanging? Why were the teacher's eyes acting crazy?
Why?
Because she couldn't control her pupils.
Hello, my name is Finley Olaf. Gymnastics starred by Finley Olaf. Cartwheel, handstand, double back flip. Be careful on the beam because you might just slip. When I'm on bars, I'm really, really busy. Then I realize, ooh, I just got dizzy. Next to vault, then to the floor. I give it my all, but I always have more. I practice really hard and it will take me far. If I keep this up, I'll be a gymnastics star.
I'm Samantha Preston. My topic is the parts of the neurological system, but I'd really like to go deep down the memory bank. The memory bank has parts to it, including frontal lobe, amygdala, hippocampus, and the temporal lobe. The hippocampus holds long-term memories, the temporal lobe stores data, the frontal lobe holds short-term memories, and the amygdala controls emotions. I hope you learned a lot about the memory bank.
Hello, my name is Harper Heck, and I am reading two poems by myself. I am a great reader. I wonder how many books I have. I hear Peyton knocking. I want more books. I am a great reader. I wish to read 100,000 books. I pretend to fly. I feel happy. I worry Peyton will come into my room. I smile at Peyton goofing off. I am a great reader. I say, get out of my room, to Peyton. I dream about being a nurse. I try to wash the dishes well. I hope to clean the environment. I am Harper Heck. Nature. When you step outside, there is grass and feet. Birds are chirping, sound so sweet. Waves are foaming, must be beach. In fresh air, eating a peach. Birds are chirping, sound so sweet. Waves are crashing, foam on feet. In the meadow, grass feels neat.
Requiem by Paul Fleischman.
Paralyzed sphinx moth, grant them rest eternal. Maple moths, let light undying shine upon them.
Praying mantises,
green darters, rest eternal.
Black-winged damselflies,
brown darters, life undying. Grasshoppers,
three-crested fur-throated,
three-banded katydids,
round-headed northern gladiator,
cave-crickets, mole-crickets, tree-crickets, field-crickets.
Grant them rest eternal.
Give them light undying.
This past night, we had the fall's first killing frost.
Hi, I'm Faith, and I will be reciting Harlem by Langston Hughes. What happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun, or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat, or crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags like a heavy load, or does it explode? Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kara Freed, and I'm going to be reading My Cat is Fat by James McDonald. I have a cat named Stella, and she eats all day. She always lays around and never wants to play. not even with a squeaky toy nor anything that moves. When I have her exercise, she always disapproves. So we put her on a diet, but now she yells all day. And even though she's thinner, she still won't come and play. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Giselle, and I will be reciting I Dream a World by Langston Hughes. I dream a world. I dream a world where man, no other man, will scorn. Where love will bless the earth and peace its path adorn. I dream a world where all will know sweet freedom's way. Where greed no longer saps the soul. No avarice blights our day. A world I dream where black or white, whatever race you be, will share the bounties of the earth and every man is free. Where wretchedness will hang its head and joy like a pearl attends the needs of all mankind. Of such I dream my world.
Hi, my name is Wisdom, and I'm going to be reciting Come to the Beach. Come to the beach where the sea is blue and little white waves come running at you. A wave comes splashing over your toes. You just stand still, and away it goes. We'll build a castle down by the sea and look for shells if you'll come with me.
Willie was a man without fame, hardly anybody knew his name. Crippled and limping, always walking lame, he said, I keep on moving just the same. Solitude was the climate in his head, emptiness was the partner in his bed. Pain echoed in the steps of his tread, he said, I keep on following where the leaders led. I may cry and I will die, but my spirit is the soul of every spring. Watch for me and you will see that I'm present in the songs that children sing. People called him Uncle Boy and Hay, said you can't live through this another day. Then they waited to hear what he would say. He said, I'm living in the games that children play. You may enter my sleep, people my dreams, threaten my early morning's ease. But I keep on coming, following, laughing, crying, sure as a summer breeze.
Hello, I am Austin Hendrick. I am reading Wave of Warrior Kid by Jack O'Willink. Fear is normal. In fact, fear is good. Fear is what warns you when things are dangerous. Fear is what makes you prepared. Fear keeps us out of a lot of trouble. There's nothing wrong with fear. But fear can also be overwhelming. It can be unreasonable. It can cause you to freeze up and make bad decisions or hesitate when you need to act. So learn to control fear. And that is the way you should do everything, the absolute best you can. Give it everything you've got, 100%. That will get you where you want to be. No matter what you're doing in life, you can't take your eyes off the long-term goal, especially to celebrate. You can assess and you can try to figure out some lessons you learned, what you did right and what you did wrong. You can even do a little bit of celebrating for the smaller victories, but don't go overboard. You have to keep your head in the game.
I'm Elijah, and I'm going to read Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. Whose woods are these? I think I know. His house is in the village, though. You will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near. Between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sound, the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep, but I've promises to keep, and miles to go before I sleep. and miles to go before I sleep.
Hi, I'm Cece, and this is Don't Quit. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and when you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is queer with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns, and many a failure turns out when you might have won if he'd stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow, you may succeed with another blow. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup, and he learned too late when the knight slipped down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are, it may be near when it seems afar. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit, it's when things seem worse that you mustn't quit.
Success is like anything worthwhile. It has a price. You have to pay the price to win, and you have to pay the price to get to the point where success is possible. Most important, you must pay the price to stay there.
Hi, I'm Henry. If you think you're beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win but think you can't, it's almost a cinch you won't. If you think you'll lose, you're lost. For out in the world you'll find, success begins with a person's faith. It's all in the state of mind. For many a race is lost before even a step is run, and many a coward falls before even his work's begun. Think big and your deeds will grow. Think small and you'll fall behind. Believe you can and you will. It's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. You've got to think to rise. You've got to believe in yourself before you can win the prize. Life's battles don't always go to the strongest or fastest man, but sooner or later, the one who wins is the one who thinks he can.
I am not for everyone. I know my truth. I know who I am. I know what I do and do not bring to the table. I'm not easy to deal with, but I do bring tons of value. I bring love and strength, but I'm not perfect. And if I don't fit in with a person or group, that is okay with me.
Hi, my name is Malcolm Walker. And 2 years ago, if you were here, Kwame Alexander came to our school, and he was doing like a book giveaway thing, and I have one of his books. So I'm doing three poems from that book. So the first one is, I like yours, your, celebrating E.E. Cummings. I like my shoes when they're with your shoes, mostly the Cummings, leastly, the goes. I carry your footsteps, 1, 2, 3, 4, in between today, tomorrow, again, and again, and again. I like to feel the flowers and the flow to your lead. It is such a happy thing to yes the next with you, to walk on magic love rugs beneath the what and why nots, the anything's up. Like every blooming thing, 4 feet, 2 hearts, one great, great, great us going, by Kwame Alexander. Snapshots, celebrating Nikki Giovanni. People forget, poetry is not just words on a page. It is snowflakes, a snowflake on your tongue, a tattoo on the inside of your arm, a dashiki in a kaftan dripping down the streets of Lincoln Heights, shouting from the hills of Knoxville, Tennessee. Poetry is barbecue, cotton candy, Purple Skin Beats from Daddy's Garden Blues, The Birdland Jazz Club, Sunday Morning Gospel, Chasing Justice, Freedom. Poetry is remembering the things that matter, the ones you love, When Night Comes Softly, Like Ripples on a Pond, by Chris Cordially. Walter, age 10, celebrating Walter Dean Myers. I'd like to soar one day, like sweeter Clifton High above the rim. I want to trot the globe, grab the world in my hand, and twirl a big ball of hope from corner to corner. Yeah, Daddy, as soon as I get me some wings, I'm going to name the stars after my buddies, put them each in a story of their own. So we never forget the summers we've spent watching Sweetie's Double Dutch, stealing pop bottles from Miss Lomax, balling on the blacktop, fighting our way home after we won. Yeah. One day I'll stand on my stoop, look at all the nurses, the poets, the workers, the hustlers, and color them my heroes, beautiful and brilliant heroes, bouncing them around here in Harlem. By Kwame Alexander.
Oh, the beauty I can see, sitting under a tree, brighter than a million stars staring at me. It all reminds me of the little kid I used to be. The ropes of the swing never try to flee, braids of love and prosperity. Here I come to set myself free. The tree it hangs on, the way it sits on the lawn, so crisp and strong. If I want to, it can take me to Hong Kong. I sit there for so long, I hope it'll be there when I'm gone. Reality is so fine, a thin line, but here there are none, no line. You're free, but it's back to the world, reality.
They call us comedy grits. Common, the injustice. As if to be so white that snow is filled with envy. Clouds consume the spite. That milk should seem molasses.
Things as ordinary. Gold should be so slender.
Diamonds
scorned as worthless.
Rubies spurned. Comedy grits are but common.
Thank you all so much for joining us today for our Lower School Oratorical Program. Let's give all of our participants a round of applause. Thank you all very much. We hope that you have a wonderful weekend.